guy's a complete team player. Whatever you need him to do, when you need him to do it. And then when you talk about how he runs bigger than he is. Run between the tackles, very explosive, very athletic. Got really good hands. Just a heck of a player.
There's definitely a torch that is to be passed. These young guys are coming who haven't been in it for a long time or haven't been in it before.
Foster snapped to Haynes in the pocket, fires right side of the end zone, incomplete. Arnold with the coverage. Alabama defeats Texas A&M.
When the process is right, the results are there.
You ain't gonna get it. They ain't gonna give it to you.
Get there the same way you just got here. One play at a time, one situation at a time. Love, trust, and believe. Stay true to the process. Everything will be good.
We do things right. We're always going to do things right. We're always going to be here.
We're going to dominate today. Put your will upon it.
They call it an off week in some cases, but there's still plenty of work to put in. There may not be a game on Saturday, but every day must be one used to get better.
Knowing it'd been a bye week, a lot of guys could have came in with the mentality of sluggish or not really trying to be there. But I feel like once we hit the field, we turned that switch on and we was all locked in and ready to practice.
I think you can't let a week go by and come back into the week of preparation, you know, out of shape or not having taken any steps towards playing South Carolina. Bye weeks are super crucial. They're super important for, you know, getting guys healthy or a little banged up. Also, just kind of getting some younger guys in there and letting them get some more reps so that they can, you know, stay fresh and stay ready. And, you know, as the season goes on, there's some guys who we're going to need in this second half stretch.
I mean, we treat it like any other week. It's all about the preparation. So we go through it like we got a game that Saturday, so it's really not much that's changed.
And not just to get better, but to get healthier. The training staff stays busy, especially in the middle of the SEC grind.
The bye week is a good chance for us to kind of look at what we got injury-wise and manage those injuries as best we can and realize that bye week is not an off week, right? A lot of times it is hard to understand that. Movement a lot of times is the best medicine. The biggest part for us is probably not having a game on Saturday and not having the full speed impact, the full speed collision. And that gives us as much of a chance as anything to rest some guys and to avoid some of that that kind of weekly grind and weekly push. Yeah, so the name of the game these days is really recovery. In order to be your best, you gotta practice every day. You gotta practice your best every day. And to do that, you wanna feel your best. And so, you know, our practices and across the landscape of college football, it's a grind. It's a hard on your body every day. And stacking that up day after day will start to wear you down. And so how you recover every day really becomes a big piece of it. Any given week, you can look at the results on the field and have a sense of pride in getting X, Y, or Z player back in.
The schedule a student athlete keeps is considerable. That's because a substantial priority is placed on the student aspect, keeping the academic staff in the middle of the plan.
As scholastic supervisors or the academic support services for the team, we're responsible for really tracking and monitoring all that goes into their academics, helping make sure that they stay on track and know what they have going on each day, helping communicate all those different requirements and things with their major and with travel and making sure the coaches are aware of how our students are doing. We communicate with parents. A lot of interaction with our students every day. We see our student athletes pretty much everyone every day. And so it is a lot of time and that we're spending with them and doing something that some of them really love in academics and some of them don't or don't feel as confident with. And so being able to really get to know them and what works for them and what their strengths and abilities are and who they are as people really makes a big difference and is a big part of why I love what I do. Being a student athlete is a big commitment. It's not just a physical commitment, but it's also very mental and emotional. And so the fact that we were able to have our fall break academically on Monday and Tuesday in the same week as bye week, so it gave our student athletes on Monday, they had the day off academically and from football. And that just very rarely is able to happen mid-season. A really good opportunity for them to just kind of take a breath and reset a little bit.
Still lead 5 yards plus on second and goal. King fires, touchdown Aggies, and it's Moose Muhammad. King's gonna go deep, got a man wide open, and he got it all the way to the 25, and it's Moose Muhammad.
A stutter on the safety this time. Oh yes, made him think slant and went right by him.
What a catch too.
The versatile Anias Smith went down in September with injury. Someone has to step up. That someone is the ultra-talented Moose Muhammad.
Man, Moose, he's a real passionate guy. Let's just say that he's real passionate about everything that he does. He loves football, definitely loves, you know, the work that you have to put in to be able to be great. He's always, you know, on the third level trying to watch film, like do extra things to make sure that his body is right in the training room, outside of the training room, in the weight room, all types of things.
It's Moose, like it's be understood already. Like it's already like, you know Moose gonna make crazy catches. Like, and it's just like a part of him. Like this, like if he had a bio, crazy catch would be in his bio. Like you know that's gonna happen. Like it's already understood what he gonna do.
Oh man, he's stepped up huge. Moose is somebody who's kind of a nonchalant character. He's like, hey, you know, I'm out here to do my job. I'm gonna get it done, and that's kind of what he does. He's just kind of, I'm in, I'm ready to go, let's go. He has some of the best hands that I've ever seen in terms of, you know, just being able to, the ball's not necessarily on target just to make it work. Like, and it just sticks. And, you know, guys oftentimes just yell stickies at him because his hands just, it's wild, you know, ball might not be anywhere near him and he's just doom, back in and it's just stuck.
I would say I'm about my business. I would say my game is definitely far from one dimensional. I just go play ball, man. I'm just there when they need me, there wherever they need me, you know what I mean? That's the way it's been.
Moose came to A&M from Charlotte, North Carolina, home of the Carolina Panthers. The team his father, Musine, played for 11 seasons of a 14-year NFL career. Moose has followed in his dad's footsteps, but is ready to blaze his own trail.
I feel like Moose has it good because his dad, you know, played the same position as him, had a career in the NFL, but also they share the same name, but Moose trying to make his own legacy. And his dad is like allowing him to do that. It, you know, like it's not a force. It's like whatever Moose wanna do, Moose can do. And like his family support him behind it like full-heartedly.
I think everybody does, you know? Like everybody's paving their own way, going about their own responsibilities day in and day out. So I think that's something that everybody looks forward to doing this. Creating their own way, their own legacy, but man, much respect. I gained so much knowledge from that man, so I can't thank him enough.
The Pulse, Texas A&M football, is presented by 44 Farms, the official beef of Texas A&M Athletics, and ABC Home and Commercial Services, official pest control partner of Texas A&M Athletics.
The Aggs, with the bye week behind us, the Aggies set their sights on the second half and winning out the final six games. That all begins tonight against South Carolina. And that's where we are, Williams-Bryce Stadium.
We got to fight for the man. Look out for the effort, get for the puck. You're going all night. It's our time to play our game, and that's it. It's the same now.
We talked about all year, right? And like the theme of this unit and of this team and of this defense has always been about next, right? Regardless of circumstances, it's about next. What do we control? How do we control it? And how do we improve? Right? That's all it's been about. Okay? This last half of the year is going to be like the story is going to be written by us. I hope each and every guy in this unit understands that. Right? We write this story.
So let's go.
Next on three. 1, 2, 3. Next.
Come on up, guys. Come on up. Here's the key. Don't press yourself. Enjoy yourself.
That's right.
And enjoy your eyes, what you do, how you do it. You know how to do it.
Right.
Play loose, play fast, play aggressive. There's a hell of a football team in there. Have fun with what you do. We're going to be aggressive on defense, on offense, on special teams, everything we got. So have fun. Love, trust, and believe in each other. You're living your dream, man. You're living your dream of what you want to do your whole life. You're where you want to be. Take advantage of it. More importantly, have fun with it, man. Have fun with it. Sun will come up tomorrow. Trust your eyes. Trust everything you got. Love, trust, and believe in yourself. The guy beside you, the organization, what your coaching is, and everything. We believe in you.
Yes,
go play some A&M football. Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
Let's go right now.
And off the right foot of Caden Davis. Leggett Fields, 2 yards inside his end zone, runs inside the hashes and the numbers, cuts to the outside, across the 20 to the 25, still on his feet from the Aggie sideline, still on his feet, down that right sideline, and 102 yards later, Xavier Leggett, a kickoff return for a touchdown. Special teams, opportunistic South Carolina has a 7-0 lead on Texas A&M. Haynes, pocket, completed midfield. Fake to A-Chain. Haynes throws right side. Stewart comes back. It's picked off. And down the left sideline, the South Carolina sideline at the 20, the 15, pushed out of bounds at the 7 by Devon A-Chain. The interception by Darius Rush. And the first time this defense is on the field on a first and goal at the 5. Spencer Rattler up the middle. Nowhere to go. Third and goal from the 5. Rattler straight back. Lobs. End zone. Incomplete.
They're going to go for the field goal.
Mitch Jeter is a perfect 6-for-6 from field goals. That kick is good. An interception return, but the Aggies defense holds South Carolina to just a field goal. Aggies down 10-0. And the snap. Haynes was going to the line. It's fumbled. South Carolina has it to the 19-yard line. A kickoff return, an interception, and a fumble for the Aggies to start this game.
Slipping from the start. Carolina is out to a 17-0 lead on a slew of A&M mistakes. But the Aggies manage a couple of field goals, one late in the first, the other early in the second. The Aggs are beginning to find their footing.
Right to left, the fake to A-Chain from his own end zone. The throw completes across the 20-yard line. Devon up the middle, and a whole lot of room. He's at midfield, goes to the right side in front of the Aggie sideline. 40, 35, dragged down at the 32. Devon A-Chain with a big run. King retreating, middle screen. Devon keeps his balance to the 24, making the 23-yard line. Puts his left hand down and got 7 more yards. Third and goal from the 9. Now A-Chain to the left of Matthew Wyckoff. In the pocket, Haynes recovers his balance, thrown, end zone, Max right across the goal line, touchdown Aggies, he caught it at the 1, spun, put the football across the goal line before he was dragged back, 9-yard touchdown Max Wright. 2-point conversion for the Aggies, down 17-12, 2 minutes left. Haynes in the shotgun, left, fired, 2-point conversion is good, it's 17-14. Spinning that ball in the end zone is Evan Stewart, the 2-point conversion, and the Aggies have scored the last 14 points and trims South Carolina's lead to 17-14.
Back in it. By halftime, a brand new ball game.
Great response for our guys, great poise for our guys. Get back in the game. Now we got to play a great second half. Very important, I think, in this first drive, the second half, we can get down and get some more. We're moving the football. It's got to keep finishing drives. Guys are making plays there. It's got to keep our poise and go play a great second half.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
The Pulse, Texas A&M football, is presented by 44 Farms, the official beef of Texas A&M Athletics, and ABC Home and Commercial Services, official pest control partner of Texas A&M Athletics.
These are the ones you remember right here, man. These are the ones that are character builders that you build your foundation of what you're doing. You've done a hell of a job to take the best shot they had coming out of the blocks. Yeah. Had a kickoff, got a couple of turnovers, up 17-0, rock. What do? We come right back and just stopped them on defense, and offense went right back to what? Moving the football, scoring points. And our defense, keep doing the things you're doing. Controlling third downs, red zone, doing a good job. Get off the field on third and offense. Keep pounding, mixing it up. Keep your poise on the snap. We're running it, mixing it, playing a hell of a football game, guys. You've outplayed them in the game, but we give them some mistakes early. Come on, guys. That's right. Love, trust, and believe in each other.
That's not finished, bro. Hey, finish on three. 1, 2, 3, finish.
A&M moved the ball to start the half, but stalled out and punted. The defense has to stifle Carolina.
First and 10. Pressure down. Third tackle for loss. Across the middle, terrific coverage. Andre White Jr. nearly intercepted. Damani Richardson. Quickly, tempo. Bouncing to the outside. Yes. He doesn't even get close to being back to the line of scrimmage. Taken down in the backfield. That is Chris Russell Jr., and now it's fourth down.
The Gamecocks score late in the third quarter, and after the Aggies punt, they have a chance to put the game away with another sustained drive. This is when someone in maroon has to make a play.
They'll start at their 30 with two receivers going to the right. Back to the left of Spencer Rattler. Pressure coming from Diggs. It's fumbled and picked up by Texas A&M at the 24-yard line. Fadil Diggs with the big hit, forcing the fumble. Aggie football. Bryce Anderson comes up with it again. Here at the 24-yard line of South Carolina. Pitch, A-chain, right side, A-chain inside the 20, a 5-yard gain to the 19, a 2-back backfield. Le'Veon up the middle, bounces off, dragging a defender, first down to the 15-yard line. Back A-chain, first down, more, touchdown, 6 for 6, Devon A-chain, the 15-yard touchdown run.
And Devon A-chain breaks that first tackle and he's gone. There's nobody that can touch him or tackle him. Touchdown, Aggies.
Let's go! Left side trying to bounce outside, cannot! Undercut by Tyreek Chappelle. Spencer Rattler fires, back shoulder throw. Incomplete! Coverage by Deuce Harmon. Right up the middle, Haynes avoids, throws on the run, incomplete. Haynes is now down at the 34-yard line. So it is Connor Wegman for Texas A&M. He's going to make his debut on the 3rd and 5. Wegman, complete, Evan Stewart, and he's shy of midfield.
An injury to quarterback Haynes King forces freshman Connor Wegman into action. The Aggies can't find the end zone, and then Carolina does. Down 30-21. A&M has to quicken the pace. Maybe throw in a quick prayer to win this one.
Across the middle, behind Donovan Green, who makes the grab. Wegman, flag is down in the secondary. Complete to Muhammad to the 46-yard line. Here comes pressure from Sherrod Green. He finds Devon A-chain, avoids a tackle at the 50 to the 45, the 40, and out of bounds. Wegman fires across the middle, complete. Yule Keith Brown wrestled down at the 7. They're going to kick the field goal
and then try the onside
and try the onside kick. 28-yard attempt for Randy Bond, and it's 30-24. Both Bond and Davis there. Bond approaches. Now Davis kicks to the left, takes the bounce. Aggie's got it. Running to the 40-yard line is Jacoby Matthews. With 10 seconds left.
It was a perfect kick. It went over the front line and in between the back line. The Aggies will have at least one play, maybe two.
He rolls to his right. He's going to throw towards the end zone. It's going to be shy of the end zone, knocked down at the 9. 1 second left. Wegman rolls to his right, steps back to his left, and it's deflected, and the Aggies ball 30-24 to South Carolina.
All right, guys, listen. Come on now. Like I said before, when you got to cling together, but listen, had opportunities. Didn't start it off right. Started from the get-go on the I got the kick, we got it going. And offensively, we didn't get anything going, two drives in a row. And defense, we played really well. And offense, you took it back, had great poise in the thing, got yourself back in the position to do it. Now we just got to learn to finish, guys. Got to learn to finish on offense, defense, but all three had a chance. And at the end, you still had a chance. You still gave yourself a chance. Your heart and your soul, we still a good football team here, guys. We just got to quit doing the self-inflicted wounds and the little things and what we have to do. And listen, it's frustrating. It's very frustrating. I get it, man. It's frustrating. And that's where you can find it. Keep your poise. There's nothing going to gain out of losing the cool, getting mad. You know what I'm saying? You got to figure out, look at why we're doing it, what's happening. We'll evaluate everything. Get back. Your heart, your soul, you played hard, man. You played hard. We just didn't make enough plays at the right time in the critical moments of the game when we switched the momentum. Did some tremendous things, defense. Tremendous, great. Some turnovers. Offense, you went in and scored on them. Did some things there. You had two long drives. At the end, give yourself a chance at the end. But the defense, you got to stop down there on fourth down. That was critical. But we got to make those plays a little bit earlier and get a jump, get out of the blocks better and not get behind the eight ball. That's what happened. When you get behind, as I would say, you can't ever win it in the first five. You can put yourself behind the eight ball, and that's what we did. And we got to get better at that, and we got to look at it. But we'll look and evaluate, okay? It's frustrating, I know. Right now, just keep your poise, get ready to come back to work on Monday, and go be a good Ole Miss team. Go be a good Ole Miss team. We can do it right back. We'll get home for the next 5 weeks and finish this season the right way.
What we just told him, we can't shoot ourselves in the foot coming out, but love your resilience, love your competitiveness. We can't do that, and we know point the things out when we got to execute at the right times and why they're happening and what we're doing and evaluate everything and be honest with you. Honesty is what you have. There ain't no trickery on this thing. You be honest with them, look them, and our kids know it, and they believe in what we're doing. They wouldn't be playing as hard as they're playing and doing the things they're doing. We just got to help them out and find ways to hit them at a few other times in some critical moments.
Coach, thanks.
Thank you.
We'll get the players in here.
The Aggies' last two losses have come down to the final play. Dejecting, of course, but they have to stay on course. The work continues to find that one more play, as the win column is not that far away.
You got to have urgency, but you can't pressure yourself so hard and I think sometimes we got to have a little more poise in key situations to be able to make the tackle, make the throw, make the run, make the block, make the, you know, whatever, kick, the catch, whatever it is, and keep a little more poise in what we're doing. And sometimes you can try too hard, and I know that sounds crazy, and put too much pressure on yourself, but you gotta have the urgency. Pressure's always gonna be there, but you gotta have urgency to get it done, and we gotta find a way to get over that hump.
The long road trip is over. This team needs Kyle Field and the 12th man more than ever.
I mean, it has been a long time, but that's the hand you're dealt, and you got to go play them. And good thing, hopefully now we get the next 4 out of 5 here, so hopefully that'll make a difference. But that's tough. But we were right there to win those games and had opportunities to do it.
Does that make Kyle Field feel a little extra nice?
Oh, it always feels good when you walk back in here, Kyle Field. I mean, the fans and the people and just the whole environment and atmosphere.